up, people? Hope you're having a great Monday. It's the start of the week. What are you going to do? It's the start of the week. That's all you can say. I'm really excited about our project today. My name is Michael Jolly. I am the bald bearded builder, and we're going to build some stuff today. We're going to write a little Vue.js app. It's going to be really stupid. Nothing fancy about it. Basically like some big buttons. Build a Vue.js app, put it in a Docker container, push that Docker container to Azure, and then deploy that container to a Raspberry Pi. But then we want to set up the Raspberry Pi to load Chromium in full screen, incognito, just the browser to like localhost 3000. We want to do the do, not do the don't. We want to do the do. This is code, code, code. Yeah, let's do the code. Let's get on over there. See ya over there. What's up? Let's do the do. Let me start off by saying this stream is sponsored today by Azure. They had this Raspberry Pi coding. It's basically like learning IoT stuff in the cloud. It's free. You learn code skills, which is pretty cool. Go through it. It's a free learning thing. And then you get registered for a free Raspberry Pi, which I can tell you, I've got tons of them. Let's do this voodoo that we do. So let me show you what I've got so far. I built a little Vue.js app. It's not done at all. That's what we're going to run in the Pi. And actually, over here, see the little window right here? It probably looks like there's nothing there. But I've got this little thing, this little deal here. It's a keyboard and mouse for the Raspberry Pi. I can use this mouse if I need to. So once we get this thing, it's supposed to be touch enabled. Anyway, I've got that Raspberry Pi raring to go. I've already installed the things that would let it connect to the Azure IoT Hub. So I've already set up an IoT Hub. It was super easy to do. I just created a resource group, hit add, IoT Hub, go through the rigmarole that it do. Let's go build the app that should run on it. You ready? I got VS Code open. Let's connect up our themer extension so you can change my VS Code theme with the theme command. I used the Vue CLI to create a project. You can see it's got this hello world garbage that it has by default. I don't want any of that. I've got a message component that I created that's completely empty. Haven't done it yet. What I'm thinking is we could do something. I mean, super simple. I'm not that good of a developer. I can't make anything complicated. It's got to be easy. I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. So tell us what you want, what you really, really want. I'm sorry about that. That was uncalled for. What I'm thinking is the top little portion of that window will have just an area for the message, and then maybe have a button in the center or maybe somewhere. So I'm thinking just have like a real refresh button, right? Whenever you want a new message, you just press refresh. It makes a call out to some kind of cloud API. Okay, we'll need like another button over here with pretend that's a gear. Trust me, that's a gear. Something like that. And when you click on the gear, and then we'll save that locally, and then we'll when we hit this, we'll say, hey, go give me a random message for this person. Does that sound good? All those in favor say aye. So let's say div app. Let's have another div because we built Div City in VS Code. Let's add script. Just some JavaScript, please. Let's be semantic in our HTML. How about that? Instead of a div, let's make it an article. Look at you, fancy pants. Then our message won't have an aside. It'll have a main state. State.twitterid. Dispatch this get tweet. So we're going to call out the state and say, hey, look, go get the next tweet. And then if we do have your Twitter ID and there's not a current tweet, then we'll say you're a beautiful butterfly. Perfect. We haven't styled this at all, so we'll want to come back and do that. But otherwise, that's done. And then we did do controls, right? This is not too bad so far. And then this is going to be an aside. All right. So what happens if we do npm? Does that work? So that's going to run, I think, on 8080 or 3000. Yeah, there we go. So we got two buttons now. So let's change that look. App view. Like, let's just say article here. HTML body article. I do want you to have a little margin at the bottom. There you go. Perfect. Okay, so now we got some tags in there that we can be all fancy about. They don't do anything. Refresh should be doing. What's our problem here? Let's start over. Why did that blow up? Oh, I didn't have those methods yet. I think message we've got done. It's getting those out of that. Let me see. We need to go call something here. It's going to call get tweet by default when you launch it. So I think all that's left is coming up with the settings. Let's do this. Let's say div and do it one more again. I'm going to take that out, which means I don't need this. Okay, so I'm going to have a separate control for settings, which means I'm done with this view. So new file. Something. What are we going to dispatch? We're going to say set Twitter ID. When we save that, we're going to say this.editing. This, let's say edit. Oh my. Is that 2 to 2? That's a hard nope, champ. Did I not register it? Okay, settings. If I click that, it opens up the text box with the Twitter ID. There it is. That's my ID. Okay, so I'll plug that in. Refresh one more again. So I'll go settings, enter the Twitter ID, save it. Didn't get anything back. I think we're almost done. Oh my. Yeah, she. Settings. Paste. Save. It works. It pulled it out of local storage and automatically pulled the first tweet. All right, so our app works like a champ. Now I want to add a Docker file, and it's using Vue. So I'm going to just steal the heck out of this for a second and then modify it for my needs. So I think I want to npm I express. Okay, so that building for production, build done, perfect. Let me go over here and look at Docker. What you got running over here, Docker? Publish. Yeah, Pexy, good job. Docker run. Let's try it now. Localhost 8080. Bam, that's it. Awesome. So then I need to go remember my ID. Settings. Works like a champ. Works like a little champ. Good boy. Okay, so we've got a Docker container. We've got that. Let's call this target. Okay, so tag that. And now let me do Docker push. So we're pushing it to Azure's container registry like a boss. So if I go in there now, awesome view, go to the edge. Our device should be down here. Create a deployment. Awesome IoT. Next is that repository. I can't remember if I'm doing this right because it's been a long time since I did this. It's like that / awesome view. So it tells me it's running the IoT Edge agent and hub on the Raspberry Pi. It's just got a touchscreen turned on, and we're going to run an app that shows like any messages from Awesome.io on it, like a random one. And it'll have a refresh button that we could press to get like a new little friendly message. Barry, sudo reboot. You have lost your connection, sir. I'm going to open Chromium on it and go to 8080. Local. Okay, it's showing the hub is green. So hopefully it'll start receiving messages to publish that. Do it. Load it. Oh my, indeed. It did. It loaded the browser full screen incognito at localhost 8080. So if we can get the Docker container running on the Pi, it'll be a kiosk. So that part's done. We just got to get it deploying there. Let's do --- push. To push result image into registry, use --- push. I think that's what I want. Did it do it? Refresh. Linux ARM. Yes. Let's see. Refresh. 104. It's been up for 39 seconds. So it's running, and it says its port is forwarding 8080. Look at this Raspberry Pi. What if I hit reload? Yes. I want to see it happen. Settings. It's going to provide me this. What the heck? Look at that. Awesome. BBB, the 7, great work. Awesome. So we did the do, people. We got that thing running on that Raspberry Pi over there. I'm so stoked how this turned out. Thank you so much to everybody for hanging out with me today. Thanks to Azure for sponsoring today's stream. It's always the best parts of my week when I get to hang out with all of you. Peace out.